Good evening, my YouTube viewers. It is Crystal here, and I'm making a code review, but the problem is that the code review is not on my browser. The code review is actually on Visual Studio Code, and I tried to make a video, and I can either show Visual Studio Code, or I can show the browser. But I can't show both. So in order for me to make this video, I had to copy and paste Visual Studio Code onto a Google Word document and then copy and paste the outcome of the web browser onto the Google Word document as well. That's the only way that I could do it. So that's what we're going to do. So this is the page of the blog post that I'm going to make, and I'm just going to take you through it. I haven't written any text yet, so what we're going to do is we're going to go through the code of create a Hello World web page using HTML and CSS. So HTML is hypertext markup language, and CSS is a style sheet. Now, 25 years ago, when I made my first web page, it was an Angel Fire account, I did have a stab at HTML, and then, like, my boyfriend at the time actually even bought me a book on HTML, which I still have. I still have that really old book on HTML, but HTML has made significant advances since I had that Angel Fire web page, and now they use a CSS, which you use CSS in conjunction with HTML. So basically what CSS does is CSS helps you to style all of the work in the HTML page, so you don't have to keep on reinventing the wheel. That's basically what CSS is. It's a style sheet. So the first thing we're going to do is, this is what is actually on my Visual Studio Code. And as I said, I can either show you the Visual Studio Code, or I can show you the output of the code, which is on a web link, but I can't show you both. So that's why I've had to copy and paste it. But you can see we've got our Hello World HTML. And so it starts out as HTML tag to let you know that it's HTML. And it starts out as the head. And the title of this code is Hello World. And then we get a link to a style sheet, which the ref is style.css. And so you can see that the style sheet is right here. And so we get another link, which is a style sheet to a Google APIs, and where it's going to give you some it's going to give you some icon images, and that's another link that we're going to do. So after we, and then we close the head, and then after we had, we close the head, we have the body of the program. So it's just a small little Hello World program, but H1 is going to be the highest size of the letter that you can get. Strong means it's emboldened, so you've got a big Hello World that's emboldened and large text. And then what we do is BR is a break, and then H3 is smaller than H1, and it says from, and then it's going to be emboldened Tracy in the end of H3. And then we're going to have another break. And now when we have another break, we have I, which means we're going to call up icons. So we're going to call it, and it's going to, class is going to be material icons. And we're going to call up a cloud. And then we're going to call up a class. And that's going to be the end of the body and the end of the HTML. So that's the actual code you've got in your HTML file. So now, after we've had our HTML file, now we're going to do the style sheet. And what the style sheet does is the style sheet sets the style of the entire sheet. So for HTML body, height is 100%, width is 100%, and text align is going to be center. That means it's going to be centered on the page. And then for the body, background color is going to be light blue, and opacity is going to be 0.5. You don't have to have opacity if you don't want to. And then we're going to set up H1. So that was the Hello World. The color is going to be dark blue. Border style is going to be dotted. And outline offset is going to be 40 px. Now you've got H3, which was by Tracy. Color is going to be blue violet, border style is going to be dashed, and outline offset is going to be 20 px. So now you're going to have H1, H3, and I. The border radius is going to be 25 px. And now you have I. The color is going to be cornflower blue, border style is going to be duffel, outline offset is going to be 10 px. And then so what you have to do is you have to save those. You have to save your work. You have to save the HTML file and you have to save the CSS file. And then so the CSS file has to be saved in the same directory that the HTML file is saved in. So you see here we've got Hello World and we've got CSS. So that's telling you that it's saved in the same directory. And then what you do to get it, you just double click on that, and then what will happen is the program or the web page will actually come up on the browser. So you'll see we've got Hello World and it's in enclosed in a dotted rounded box. And then you've got From Tracy, which is enclosed in a dash round box. And then you've got the cloud and the computer and round boxes as well. So that's what I created. You can see here, I created it here. And if I had wanted to, I could have had different coloring here in Hello World and different coloring here from Tracy and different background coloring. And I could have done that. And I think that I will do it. I think that I will do it now that I brought it up that I can do it. I will do it. But I just wanted to do this little video in YouTube to show you how to make a Hello World web page using HTML and CSS. So I'm going to go ahead and conclude this video because I've went through the code in both HTML and CSS to tell you how to make your Hello World web page, which you can do on your own. So thank you so much for watching my video. If you like my video, please like, subscribe, and share. And I look forward to communicating with you in the next video.